Amelia and Olivia. Our dads, me and Liz, were the first factory owls in New Zealand. Reverend Smithy Eriko started the movement of the Wepapa Sai New Zealand from 1962. My dad, Wafisa Walitia, was caught in Otara. Liz and I were the Faith the Elves daughters, groomed to marry Faith the Elves. But as you know, it wasn't God's plan. I was celebrating my 60th in Rarotonga on October the 26th, and I invited Liz 2 years ago to attend. But it wasn't meant to be, and she called me when I sent a good friend over to visit when I heard she wasn't well. And I was really shocked, because the last time I saw Liz was 2019 in October, just before we shut down. It broke my heart to see her like that. Being helpless, that I couldn't come straight away. But the day she got out of hospital, called me so I could speak to her mother. I wished her well and told her I know I couldn't make it here, and if she has to go, my heart was at peace to release her. She passed on the 17th of November while I was in Samoa, but I knew God was sending me over. I really thought when I arrived here on the 5th of December that this was all done. But you know, when God plans and orchestrates, everything is done in His time. Amen. My heart is in pieces over my passing, sis, because I will not get to see you this time around. I didn't think I will make it to your service, so I sent ahead a speech to be read out on my behalf. But you must have wanted me to be here, because you knew I was still coming, whatever the outcome. So happy we spoke a few times in October. I have that replaying the video over and over again. Thank you, Tiffany, for calling me and telling me that Mum was on the last. I wished you well on your journey, and it gave me peace in my heart to release it. Thank God for our longtime sisterhood friendship from 1966 to 2022. I traveled here every year from 2005 doing ministry, marketplace ministry. God has taken me around the world, and this was my mentor. Stop in every year just to have time with her. Later in life, she married and moved here to raise her own family. Although we lived miles apart, distance was never a problem. It was our prayers that connected us instantly to the Father's heart. This always edified and encouraged me in ministry to keep running the race. Junior and our team of LA Angels are us. He once came to San Jose to hear me preach. That was so special for me to have you witness how God uses me. Thank you for organizing my preaching engagements. When we shared the word of God, it was sharp like a two-edged sword. I love the way you expressed yourself through your writings. It was really deep. That was a God-ordained gift that you had. You had the same passion and loving God and compassion and loving God's people. Thank you for being my big sister and a kingdom role model. You were bold and fearless, a true Proverbs 31 woman, full of love. God grace and tenacity to walk daily with God. I will always hold you close to my heart as of memories that will last me a lifetime. I will continue to run this race on our behalf until my purpose on this earth is fulfilled. I know that one day we will meet. I so miss you and I will love and treasure you forever. Your work here is done, sis. You have been promoted to glory. Fly high and return home to where you belong, back into the Father's heart. Spot for you, sir. Amen. Amen.